So you've booked your certification exam, and now you want to know how to best prepare in order to have a successful proctored exam experience. Here is what you need to know. First off, make sure you have a computer and a good internet connection. If you can have a wired connection, that's better due to its reliability. It is recommended that you use a personal computer and not a work computer. Sometimes work computers can have restrictions on them that will interfere with the software used to take the exam. You are only allowed to have one monitor during the exam. If you have multiple monitors at your setup, that's completely fine. Just make sure that they are unplugged during your exam time. The space that you're in needs to be free of noise and free of distractions. You are the only person allowed to be in that space during your exam time. If you live with other people, it might be helpful to just let them know about this. Keep in mind that you are not allowed to leave your space during your exam time. The space you are in also needs to be well lit, and it is recommended that you not sit directly in front of a window or a strong light source. If you have any study material, for example, you might have some notes on a whiteboard, all that needs to be cleared beforehand. You will need to provide photos of your space during your check-in time, so make sure to have your phone on you to take those photos. During the exam, your phone will need to be nearby in the space, but not within arm's reach in case the proctor needs to contact you. One last thing, make sure you have an ID that meets the requirements. I will make sure to add a link in the show notes so you can verify that information. If you encounter any troubles before or during the exam, let your proctor know. They will try to resolve any issues in real time, and if they cannot, they will open a support case on your behalf. Support cases typically end in Pearson's issuing you a voucher for a new appointment. If you are disconnected from the proctor and you cannot resume your exam, a support case will automatically be filed for you. But you also have the option to visit the customer support page and open a support case for yourself. Alrighty, Cloud Gurus, that's what you need to know to prepare for your proctored exam. Remember to do a systems check on the computer you'll be using to take the exam. Make sure your space is quiet and free of any study materials. If you do encounter any troubles, you know where to go in order to open a support case. Much luck to you in taking your exam. If you found this video helpful, make sure to leave us a thumbs up. Let us know in the comments which exam you are getting prepared for. Don't forget to subscribe for more cloud content. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus. I'll see you in the next one.